Hey guys, it's Alicia, and today I'm gonna show you how to fix the HTTP 302 error. HTTP 302 codes are a valuable way to redirect website users to a different URL temporarily. However, if your website is delivering 302 redirects in error, it's a sign that something's wrong. Don't worry, you can fix this problem, but you'll need to do some troubleshooting. In this video, we'll share 5 tips to help you fix this error. Before we get too far though, I want to let you know, there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. So, let's get started. The very first thing you need to do is make sure to perform a complete backup of your website first. That way, if anything goes wrong, you can always revert to the previous version. You can use a WordPress plugin to do this. 302 responses are usually not errors. Temporarily redirecting users to a different page can be a valid configuration and isn't usually something that requires fixing. It's only an error if your website is responding with 302 codes that it shouldn't be issuing, or if it's causing a redirect loop. Therefore, the first step is to double check which URLs are generating the HTTP 302 codes and determine whether the redirect is appropriate or not. To do so, you can navigate to the pages on your website you suspect of issuing the 302 error and see for yourself if they behave as expected. If a temporarily unavailable page redirects to the correct resource, it's appropriately configured. However, if a page redirects you to the wrong resource or your browser reports a redirect loop by bringing up the too many redirects error page, it's a sign that one or more of your redirects isn't configured quite right. One of the most common causes of 302 errors and redirect loops is plugins. Some WordPress redirect manager plugins and SEO tools like Yoast SEO manage your website redirects for you and enable you to set up redirect rules. If these rules are misconfigured or if two plugins conflict, it can cause unexpected issues. Therefore, you'll need to check each relevant tool that's installed on your site. For example, if you're using the popular 301 Redirects WordPress plugin, you can check the configuration by navigating to Settings, then 301 Redirects. Under Redirect Rules, you'll see a list of all the redirect rules you've set up. Check all the 302 redirects listed here and make sure they're all correct. You'll also want to ensure that you haven't set up anything in a way that could cause a redirect loop. For example, if page A is set to redirect to page B, but page B is also set to redirect to page A, this will cause an error. If you have multiple redirect manager plugins and you're not sure which one is causing the issue, you can try deactivating them one by one from the WordPress plugins page, but be sure to make a backup first. After deactivating each plugin, try revisiting the problem URL to see if the 302 error persists. If the problem is suddenly fixed, you'll know which plugin was causing the issue, and you can then choose to troubleshoot further or remove it from your site. Another common cause of the HTTP 302 error is a misconfiguration in the WordPress URL settings. To check this, navigate to Settings, then General in your WordPress dashboard. Here, you should see a WordPress address field and a site address field. In most cases, the URLs in both of these fields should match. Make sure they're both the same, including the www portion, or lack thereof, before the domain name. If they don't match, update the settings, then click the URL of the page issuing the HTTP 302 error to see if it's fixed. A misconfigured server can also sometimes cause 302 redirect errors. Therefore, the next step is to check your server configuration. If your host uses the Apache web server, you can do this by checking your htaccess file. This step won't apply to sites hosted on Nginx servers. If your host uses Nginx servers, as Kinsta does, you can move on to the next step. First, connect to your site's server via a control dashboard like cPanel or an FTP client. Then, navigate to the root directory of your site. the same place as the WP admin and WP content folders, and find the htaccess file. If you aren't finding the htaccess file here and you're sure you're on an Apache server, you may need to tell FileZilla to show hidden files before it'll appear in the file list. Next, open the file in your favorite text editor. It should look something like this. Now we're going to look for rewrite directives. Without getting too technical, rewrite con and rewrite rule directives are used to perform redirections from one URL to another. The rewrite con directive specifies the URL you want to redirect the visitor away from, while the rewrite rule directive specifies the URL you want to redirect them to. Here's an example. This flag at the end tells the browser that this is a temporary 302 redirect. If you notice any rewrite combinations in your htaccess file that shouldn't be there, you can comment them out, save the changes, and reload the problem website to see if it resolves the issue. Just make sure to download and save a spare copy of your htaccess file before you make any changes in case something goes wrong. If you've tried all of the mentioned methods and you're still having trouble, the next step is to speak to your web host. Troubleshooting a 302 code error beyond this point requires a lot of technical know-how. Therefore, unless you're a professional developer, it's probably best to get help from an expert. At Kinsta, we take support seriously. Our team of WordPress experts is always on hand to help you resolve issues like this whenever they arise. We're available 24/7. All you have to do is log in to your My Kinsta account and contact us via live chat to connect with a support engineer who can help you in real time. Do you have any questions left about the HTTP 302 error? Let us know in the comments section. An unsecured website puts your customers and reputation at risk. With Kinsta's Cloudflare integration, all the security features you need are built right into your plan at no additional cost. That's a monthly savings of around $200 per site. Learn more about these benefits, including DDoS protection, a more secure firewall, and more at kinsta.com/Cloudflare-integration. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.